Welcome to our day 3 of Fibber Coding Academy. We are still on our HTML, and today we want to bring in a bit of CSS. Yeah, a bit of CSS. So CSS is cascading style sheet, and it's a training on its own, okay? You're going to learn that, but for now, I just want to incorporate CSS on our HTML. Just to let you know that even while working on HTML, can actually make use of CSS as well. So how do we do that? Join me, let's go to my system, so I'll show you how we can do this, okay? So this is where we stop on day 2. This is where we stop on day 2, and today is day 3. We want to add a bit of color to all this. Like I told you, CSS is just all about adding styles and color. We want to style your work, we want to color your work, that's when you use CSS. And today, let's use CSS, don't remember the formula. I gave you a day to the starting of this program. That is, you have to have your style, you have to put your dot dots with your colon, color equals to, you put your quote, then you type whatever color you want. Don't worry, let's go into action and show it. So let's start with the first one. Welcome to our training. Let's see how we can style our H1 that can look very well. This is our H1. Welcome to our training. Now, for us to style it, if you are using VS Code like me, come over here, click inside the H1 before the greater than sign, okay? Inside the H1, give a space, just one space, then type style, okay? And say VS Code help you to incorporate it immediately. So what do you see? You tell you style is equal to, like I said, then your quote. Then in between the quote, you put the what you want to put. So don't forget, if you are using the nice VS Code, you want to type it yourself, that is what you do, okay? So our style now is color. What color are we giving it? Style equals to, you put your quote color, put your semicolon, then you put the color. So let me put a color that will show that really something has happened here. If I put black, it's already black. So let's look for something special. And in color, that's what we call RGB. RGB may have 3, may have 4. If you have transparency, you have to add the fourth one, which is A, RGBA, okay? But I don't want to go into detail, just to show that you can actually incorporate color to your HTML. So it's called you want to use right now. Let's use something like green. And that is okay by me. You can choose any color you like. There's no rule to this. Any color at all that you like. If you are good in styling, you know the right color, the perfect color, mix them together. And you get a perfect start, okay? Control S for save. Let's see if it has come up. But all that, we can't see our work because that color is almost in line with our. Okay, let's change it to red then. And this is when you can use RGB. You can also type it yourself. So don't forget, you have two ways of adding color. Either to the RGB by hovering, you see RGB, or you see color palette for you to select, or you type it yourself. Let's use something like this. Maybe red will show immediately. And as usual, Ctrl+S for save. And you can see it, the red has appeared immediately. Okay? But as you're going back to use the RGB, you know that it's working. So people don't say that maybe the water has changed it. No, go back to that color. But let's see. So it's that it's working, Abby. Now, apart from adding color to your test, you can also add what is called background color. So we use background color and then bring back that RGB that we didn't use before. Because actually, the color apply. But because the color is almost the same thing with the color we have, that's why you can't see our write up again. But by the time we put background color on it, our write up will appear. So what I'm trying to say, for you to do background color, remember when I taught you about embedment, you can actually embed two things together. So you can actually embed another background color on this. How do you do that? You have tidy space, you type your background color. Okay? Put your background color. Background color. Don't forget to always space your work. Always space your background color. And don't forget, actually put the background color before the quote. It shouldn't come after the quote. Come after the quote, it won't show anything. It must be before the quote. Okay, email after your semicolon. Then you give a space, you type background color. Don't forget all these things. They are very simple, but they are very, very important. Let's give the background color to be blue. Let's put it. Let's give it brown. Okay, brown should be fine. Ctrl+S. Yeah, so that way let's go back and change this color using RGB. We already discussed what to use that for. think it was green. I wanted to use that time. Something like green light. Okay. So by what now you hover it, it will now show you the RGB for you to select. So let's use that same green color I wanted to use that time, and you see it appear right now. As usual, let's save our work. Control S for save. Did you see it? Welcome to our training. So it did appear the first time because the color is almost the same thing with the background color of our body tags. Okay. So this is how you can actually color your write-up. Now let's come over here and color the next one. Use the same pattern. Do it by yourself. If you're able to do it, then watch me as I do it. But first of all, pause this video right here. Go to this Advanced Digital Marketing. Add color to the H1 here, which is our title. Then add color to the paragraph. That is the first assignment. Do it by yourself. Don't watch what I'm doing. So pause it right now. Go and do it. If you're able to do it like this, then that is great. If you're able to do it, then come back and watch what I did, and then repeat it to the next one. This is the third one. Because I will do the first and second. So you can use the second one to relearn it again, and then do the third one yourself. Okay. Remember what we said: practice. Anything I do, practice it back. So for us to do that same thing that we did in the first, come over to your H2. Click there. When you click, give the space, first space, then you add your style. Don't forget, you must only have your style. Okay. And then after style, we are talking about color. And it's not just color. You can actually add a width, height, margin, and the rest of them. But we don't want to go into details. We are going to do CSS in detail. So no need of talking everything about CSS here. We are going to miss CSS later on. I just want to show you that you can actually color your write-up, and it will look very, very nice. Okay. So as usual, just like what we did for the first time, you give your space. You gotta type your space. You type your color. And what color I'm gonna put it this time around? Let's give him something like gold, okay? Let's give him something like gold. Let's give him a gold white work. Let's give him green yellow. Let's give him green yellow, okay? And don't forget Ctrl S for save. Yeah. So let's now add the background color to this. The color will appear very, very well, okay? Let's add the background color as usual. Type, give a space. The reason why you have this space just for it to be okay, not as if there is a something that you must give a space for it to work. No, but that space helps you to know what you are doing, help your work to be neat. Okay, but it doesn't affect our HTML. Remember what we said, that space doesn't affect it. So whether you put it, you want to space it or you don't use it, doesn't work with HTML. So what color are we going to give? Should we try azure? I've done some the same thing there already. Let's try aquamarine. Aquamarine should be okay. And Ctrl S for save. Yeah, so you see it. This color didn't show very well. Let's change it. Let's make it something like, let's add a different color. Maybe something like blue, deep blue. Let's see if we have say her. I think this is better. Or we can actually add gray, something like this. Let's our RGB now and see what we can do. Let's use RGB. Yeah. S for save. Okay, this should be okay. Let's use it. So let's go to the paragraph and let me show you also color paragraph. Do the same process, the same thing we've been doing is what you also repeat. Space it back. Come over to your paragraph with your P, give a space, then type. You can also do background color first before the main color. It all will work, okay? Let's start with background color before the main color. But don't forget to start with your style. You must start with style first, then add whatever you want to add. This time around, let's put background color. And let's make this one. This one should be something like this. Ctrl S for save. Yeah. Then let's now add our color again. Color. Let's make the color Alice blue, almost the same color that it will turn to white, okay? But the S for save. So though it's not showing very well, but you can actually put in color that make it show. You can turn this to red or to brown, any other thing that make it to appear. All I'm trying to say that if you want to color your write-up, if it's your write-up you are coloring, what you do? Just simply type color. Style equals to color. But if you are coloring the background, you use background-color. You get it? I hope you do. to color the next one, and let's see how it goes. If you do this, then let's continue our training. So is it work for you? Try your best to color this next one and see if you master this adding of color and style to your writing. I hope you're able to do that. You can also add color to the body right there on your HTML. So if you add color to the body, your whole body will turn to that color. Let's actually color our body using background color. So give a space as usual. Type your background color, your background, and choose a color that you think will be okay for you. Okay, something like gold is okay. And you can also hover it to see that the color you are choosing applies. Okay. So let's do style as usual. Don't forget it. Remember I told you before that once forget anything, it won't work. For it to work, make sure everything follows. Must follow exactly that way. Okay. So let's put black. I think this should be okay. Almost empty, but not really the same. So let's use this. And Control S as usual. Yeah, you see it? You see the color has applied. The color has applied. Though, like I always say, I would like to finish HTML first before going to CSS, which has to do with styling and color, markup, margin, so many other things that you can think of, like flex bars, grid, animation. We are going to do that live here, okay? We don't do that one, but I will start CSS. What our advice is, just calm down, finish your HTML. If you want a bit of color, you can add this few colors to your write-up or to your website that you are designing. But I'll get to CSS, we'll now go fully into color. But if you want to know more about color, I can actually take you to a website. This is the website, don't forget it, W3School. Like, type w3school.com/colors/colors_misa.asp. When you are there, each of these colors, see this is the color, you can choose any of this color. For example, maybe you want something like this. You click on it, your mouse. And when you click on it, what do? You scroll down. Just scroll down, and you see the color. This is it. This. So what you do, you just copy this color. Come over to here where you have your color. Instead of using this, remove it, just go and remove that the first time. Then paste this. And merely the color, this color will appear. This you are looking for, you do the same thing and it will appear. So you can actually scroll down and see all the colors with their codes. So if you want to use code, so people can all these codes. So when you are working, it's easy for you, just use the code 00FFFF. You know what you are doing, okay? So that makes it easy for you. If you actually want to learn this, can learn it by your heart, grab the colors and use it when you are working. Then also, you can also go to next and use RGB. Remember RGB is what we use. This RGB, RGB 65, 228, 65. These 228 are just like you are measuring the color that you are using. Green should be this color, white should be this, and black should be this. Okay, that's what RGB stands for. Red, green, blue. But that's going to be red, green, black. So it's better not just mix up the colors and know what you're doing. And apart from RGB, we also have HGX, also have HSL, also have HWB, also have CMYR, also have NCOM. All these are color. Can use percentage as well, like instead of using 64, 13, 233, for you are using CMYK, you can use percentage, maybe 25%, 30%, 20%, just like that, okay? So if you really want to learn a little about color, you can come back to the WCPA and learn a little about color. But don't worry, like I told you earlier on, paste your HTML, use this few color. But that we get to CSS, will be next week, we'll now deep dealing with color. And not just color, but other things like your margin, your padding, your pieces, you can read pieces and the rest of them. We're going to cover all that and then move on to flexbox, go to animation, and go to grid, okay? So we have a lot to learn, just calm down and continue. But if you're able to do that, I told you to do this, right? I told you to finish the remaining one, add the color, any color you like, and see if you are successful. If you're able to do that, I will tell you congratulations, you are true with color. Let's move on to the next stage.
We are supposed to talk about file.
What I don't need to talk about file, because file is something that we did in the past. I can actually create a file. For example, let me just show you how I can create a file. Let's create our package. Yeah, we're not going to use it right now, but let's create them as a way of teaching you how to create file. So like what I said in the initial stage, just move back to CEII web, which is your folder name, scroll to the first plus, click on it, and you type in your about page, okay? So let's create an about page, or just about us, all right, about us. And then you scroll, So with this, can create contact us using the same method. Able to do it fine. Just pause this video, create your contact file. And able to do it after creating yours, then look at what I did to correct yourself. So simply come over to your folder, as I said, scroll straight to the first plus, you see what they write, new file, okay? Then to create a folder, you see new folder. We are creating a file, so go back to what, new file. So click on new file, and then add your contact us page, okay? Contact us. You can also have image, because we also have the image. So same process, scroll down, come over to new file, click on it, and type your image, okay? So image will be image.png. And sorry, we are making a mistake. Don't forget we are doing it should be .html, okay? .html. But for image, it should be .png or .jpeg. But let's use .png. .png. Then for call about us, it must be about us.html, okay? Make sure that your format, your file is not always forget when you make mistake, try your best to correct it, okay? And that is the beauty of coding. Sometimes you may do something, if you work out well, you have to figure it out, then make some correction. Like that about page, remember what I said earlier on that you should have everything must end with .html. That's how to delete everything and start all over again. So here, you click on your new file, click on file. And type about.html, okay? .html. Don't always forget that. Then that file is created. Now go to the next one. So another file again. Contact. Might be contact us or just contact page. Anything you want to like, contact us. .html. So everything. You know why? But like I said, that way. The file, the document, the system, recognize that what you are trying to write, what you are doing is about HTML. But I'll get to CSS, you also use that method as well. JavaScript, the same thing. Okay? So that is how the system recognize what you are doing. Otherwise, they don't know what you are doing. Okay? So you have a part of HTML, method.html, therefore image will be image.png. So this is how you create files. Not the way you created that index.html file administrative. So I believe with this, you now know how to create files. Than your VS Code, okay? And I will use method to welcome you all back on the intermediate level. At least we are now on intermediate level. If you're able to read this, I'll tell you welcome, okay? So from intermediate, we go to advanced. So everything I did now, know that what I did now is all intermediate in HTML, intermediate HTML. You are no more the baby of yesterday in HTML, no. You are now on intermediate level. So, having said this, let's go to the next one, which has to deal with formatting. How do you format your page? For example, you have created a website. How do you format that will look pretty good? Okay, let's jump in there and see how we can do this together. So, as an intermediate level, you should know how to format your HTML. And for you to format your HTML, three basic things have to apply. Yes, your header, your name, and your footer. Well, I know you guys have seen a website before, you know how websites are composed of. For example, your header, which is here, you can see your about page, your contact us page, your maybe home page, and stuff like that on top. Top move, you can see your pictures, your add to cart, and stuff like that. There's always, it's majorly navigation link, your navigation, your links, and your logo. Those are things you see. At the head of your website, okay? Then after that, the next one is your mail. The mail will be like kind of, let me say the body, let me say what body, the mail. So on that mail, I see what you are, what your website is all about. Maybe you have sessions, session for this, session for that. It's all that selling products, session for shoes, session for cosmetics, session for maybe clothes and stuff like that. Okay. Then on that same mail session, also have be like your article. Maybe your blog post, article, write-up, the amount, the detail, the prices, whatever your thing is made up of. That is your skill. You also write about yourself, your skills and stuff like that. Okay? Then at the down part, you see your footer. Your footer, that's the third one. And the footer, that's where you put your maybe like social, your social media, you have one put to direct to your maybe your WhatsApp, your Twitter, Facebook, and stuff like that. So that is how websites supposed to be. That is how you format it. So you format it based on that. How do you do that? follow bar is going to be your header, as I said. So you click on your header and you bring it down. Inside the header, you have your navbar, or you call it navigation menu. And the navigation menu is where you put about us, contact us, and stuff like that, your homepage, and other things, maybe your logo and the rest of them, okay? So by the time we get there, you will see how these things are done. But now, just have the kind of skeletal outlook of how these things are done, how they are formatted. But I will now start pricing it one after the other. We are putting them there. Well, that, like, these are battles that we just create, the fire battles we create, the contacts we create, and the image we created. By the time we get to list and the links, we'll be able to bring them in here. So, but also at this level will be under your header, your number, your links, and the rest of them. Okay. Then, well, after the header, the next ones come on board should be the main. Should be the main. And those ones, they should all be on the same session. Why the nav should go a little bit here, because remember, your header and your main, they are like siblings, right? They are like siblings. Remember when we talk about siblings? So here, you talk about your article, your blog, your item, your quote. So let's see, okay? Article, and you can also have session. You can have session, different sessions here. Another session, you put that one, that people session, anywhere you want, but you should be that kind of format, okay? You can have your sessions. Then under the main, you also have aside. That's what we call aside. Okay, aside. How we start working with CSS, you understand that CSS will be, so it be like here, a kind of advert, just more adverts at this corner. That is aside. Aside tag should be just like advert. Okay, like this will be the time to Google. If you are doing a what's it called? This is a Google. Let me try to remember. For example, those who have one Google page, like Google AdSense, Google AdMob, you know. Those are Google pays, okay? Those are collect money from Google. So that's where, on that ad, aside, that's where you put those ads back there. That's a lot. You also advertise your goods, your other websites, your other, maybe your YouTube, and the rest of them from that side tag. So let's create it aside tag. And remember, I say aside tag will always come at this corner, at this part of your web browser. The main idea, let's put the last one, which is footer. And what is content in footer, like I said earlier on, footer also contain maybe, media pages, the year that you just produced your website, the year that your site was completed or designed or constructed, whatever you use, then maybe copyright claim and stuff like that. Those are things that be on your website. Then maybe affiliate, if you are affiliated, like affiliate market and the rest of them, those are what should be on your future. So always try to make sure that you put your website, your formatting should be like this. There's a reason why HTML put all these things there. Some people may sometimes try to say it doesn't really matter, they'll neglect it. But to me, it matters because you make your work to be simpler. Although in the long run, I think that you make your work a little bit longer. But in the long run, it's shorter because you know you'll be able to know where you carry an article, you know where you're going to put it. You carry your image, you know where you're going to put it. So it makes things easy. You are kind of more organized when you do it that way. So I always try to commit to myself that they should always try to use HTML format when they are building their website. Let's not forget it. Let's use it. It helps a lot. So I always advise my students to always make sure that they format their HTML entirely like that. Of course, maybe that is not important, but I tell you, it's very, very important. For example, somebody like search engine like Google and the rest of them, if you format your page very well, it helps you under SEO. We understand SEO now, but most of us here, I know most of us here understand SEO, search engine optimization. But that way, Google will know your header, they will know your session, they know your main, they also know your footer. But that will be able to go and when you are crawling, they will crawl your website and know what your website is all about. But if you just arrange it just exact form, sometimes Google may not understand what you are doing. Your header is at the top, you're just like that. So always try as much as you can to make sure that you are doing your work following HTML format. They didn't put it there for nothing. And don't forget, HTML is a no-nonsense language. If you make any mistake, if you have any fluff in there, it's going to reject it and it's going to affect you. But when you do the right thing, it becomes easy for you and for those who are reading along with you. And even your fellow coders, your fellow programmers, by the time they come to your, maybe they want to check out your HTML, but they don't know what you do. They don't know where to get what. Okay? It makes your work simple. It makes it easy. I always advise you to use it. Having said this, let's move on to the next class. We'll go to the next section. And start on what next? So we've come to one of the main sessions. and that is link. Links in HTML. Have you not been browsing? Maybe you want a website to pay for an article, and then you click, it will tell you add to cart, and you click on it to add to cart, and after that you want to check out, you also take to where you're going to make payment, and you make your payment, and off you go. Those things are possible because of links. Everything is linked together. So link will take you either outside of your site or in between your site. How did I use link when creating your own website? Watch us as we do it together here and now. For example, if you go to Jumia, you want to buy an item, or you go to Facebook, you want to fill out your website, you type your name, you type your first name, your second thing, you click on enter, and it will link you to your page. Your page will open. Open that your page is what you call link, okay? So I believe I'm making sense. I'm making sense. Kindly subscribe to my channel, like, comment, and share. So each of my postings like this will be the first to get it and learn. Especially for those of us in this group, because I always try to post what I'm going to learn the next day, the day before, or sometimes in the morning before that time, okay? So subscribing to my channel, you are going to gain a lot. So let's go to link. Let me show you how link is done. Let's go to our system and hop into that. So for link starts, we're going to start with link tag. So a link, as we said, is compared to link you either to a file, to an image, to a PDF, or to other websites, as well as to every other place. So you code link. Let's come over here to my browser. As for you to use link, you must use an A tag. An A tag, okay? So if you are using the code up here, just come type A. Then you press A, you see it A for link. Press enter, and it has opened. You notice that immediately after the A, there is the pageref. Pageref stands for reference, okay? Your reference. And immediately after the reference, you have our formula, okay? Which is supposed to, then on top of it, you have your normal code, okay? So in between is where you link to. Let me know, maybe I want to link to Google this time around. What do I do? You type your Google page, which is HTTPS. Make sure that your HTTPS is there. Yeah, your column is there, and slash is there, the two slash is there, www.google.com. Make sure you type it exactly like this, okay? Don't just write www.google.com or just .com. No. Make sure that everything is complete. This is a complete complete web address. Once it's complete like this, then the next thing you do is Ctrl S for save, and let's see what will happen. Ctrl S for save. When I save, what happens? If you come over to our where we are seeing where we are working, nothing is showing out there. You look at it, nothing is showing. And you may be wondering, but I just create a link. Why is it not showing here? Yes. The reason is because you are here to put the name to let the browser know. Of course, there's a link. And the link is in there. It's in one of these places. But you can't see it because there's nothing you tell the browser to allow you to see it. So for others to see, so they can click on it, you can now come over to that same link you create. Come over to that same link. You check in the mail after your link tag, in between the closing tag and the tag of A, in between the two. So I'm talking about in between, okay? In between, you type google.com, okay? Or you can say this will link you to Google or Google link. If you want to type that, but just put Google is okay. So once you've done like this, you do your control S, it will appear now. You see it? It has appeared. These are Google. See, these are Google. So let me make it both sides what I'm talking about. Okay. So do you see Google? Now let's click on it and you take us direct to Google. Because remember you can bring your mouse there, your mouse point like a hand. And that's a symbol. It's trying to show that this is a link. But when you click on something like this, it will link you to another page. So when you see a website, you put your mouse on it, I turn to hand. That is what it's telling you. Okay. So let's click on it and it take us to Google. Wow, you see it? We are now in Google. But you notice something? It took us to Google and our website has vanished. All been creating is normal. So how do you do it in such a way that if I want people to go to your link, to other link, they should not leave your website? How do you do that? So you still have to do something. So you have to click on it, they should not leave your website. Your website will be there and it will be unlocked. Anyway, if you are maybe you are browsing, for some, you have to right click and say open in a new page or open in a new window. That's the way they format it. But to me, there's something you can do. Somebody immediately click on it, you also have to say open in a new window. Open. No. The person immediately you click on it, it you open in a new tab or a new window. That way, the person can see it, you know, your website. Because this has a disadvantage. If somebody click on this link and it leads them to Google and it's away from your site, it might get it to Google or maybe Facebook and start browsing on Facebook when that is doing something before it came over there. Okay? So, make sure your website is right there. As it's browsing, you remember that, oh, I am actually visiting a website before you come back to your website. So, don't let customers or your clients or people, users or social media guys to leave your site just because you put a link there. So, how do you do that? Come over to that same place. Then after your Google.com, tap the code, give a space, write target, okay, target, and under that target, you must put underscore blank, let me make it what I sort of mean or what I'm trying to explain, see it, so we have our href, which is Google.com, I'm looking to Google.com, but I tell them that the target, our target is underscore blank, meaning that as I'm going to Google.com, don't just go to Google. Our website is there for you. Okay, so let's see if I see how what will happen. If you want to save it on that one, I'm going to see. I'll save it. So let's come over there again. Remember, we already are out of our site, so let's open it in Lightsaver. And let's click on Google once again. Let me make it bold. So that's what I'm talking about. Let's go Google again. Google. What happened? It's now opening a new tab. These are websites, and this is Google opening. You see it? So these are how you do this. So that way, nobody will navigate out of your site. Your site will always be there. While the person, once he's finished what you link him to do here, once it's true, you will come back to your own website. Am I communicating? Is it making sense? Please kindly like, share, and subscribe. And invite more people. We need more people to learn this. But it's going to benefit all of us at the end of the day. Another thing we can do with link is that I can link within my website. That is for internal linking, okay? All we don't need was external linking, but we can also do internal linking. Where you link someone straight to your website. How do you do that? Remember, we've opened a page, have our about.html, have our contact.html, and these are what you see in a website. How do you link to your website internally? For us to do that, let me make this one bold, summarize what I've been. So let's come on, let's come there. Remember, all these are on our navbar and it's under header. Okay, remember, we'll talk about formatting. Everything must go on based on the formatting to be clean, to be clear, to be great. Okay, so let's now come down. Let me have to go about this. Okay, let's go now. Not to so let's say about page. Let's create a link that will link us to our about page. So as usual, type your A and press enter. Once your A is enter under href. What we have there in between, just where you put your Google, I'm going to put there is about.html. About.html. It has appeared. Click on it. About.html. Then in between the anchor key, which is your open tag and closing tag, you type the website you are going. And that should be about us. Okay. About us. Or about us page. About us page. Okay. Now we've created this. Let's see if it's working. Control S for save. Let's now minimize this so I can check what is going on. Yeah, look at it. About us. About us is here. And don't forget, remember, both of them are on the same line. We call this inline element. When we get there, I'm going to discuss about that. But you know, you can actually do something to bring this, to bring the Google down. Either Google should come down or about us should come down. Any of them should come down. If you bring the same line by line, you know what you can do? Have you forgotten? Please don't. Remember your A tag. When you're talking about a href, when you're talking about your A, that if you want to bring it down, you can't use the E process. But if I put enter here, let me put enter here. If I come over here and press enter, it's not going to work. What? Just watch that. Let's press enter, and then control C. Did it work? The answer is no. But remember our HR. With HR, this way work. Though HR, we put a kind of straight line on it, BR will not put any line on it. So remember your HR and your BR. We give this, we are talking about the basics, okay? So how do I bring this down? Simply put your BR, okay? Your BR. Don't forget that you need a self-closing tag. So all those things we've been learning before, as I'm going to intermediate, we now have to bring those concepts. We're bringing them one after the other to achieve your goal. So let's click on Control S. Let's see what will happen. Do you see it? The bad news is up. My Google is done. So that way somebody can click on Abaros, we can click on Rainbow. Okay, so this is Abaros. Let's go to the next one. Just this, create this into copy it, that to save our work. You're no longer being programming. So copy this, Control C for copy, and paste it like 2-3 places. Okay, and paste it again. Yeah, it should be in the third places. So here, under change the Abaros now, we're going to, the next one should be contact us. And let the first one be home page. Let the first one be home page. So everything will be more formatted. Well, go there, like formatting my page very well. So when people see, they'll say yes. Follow it. When you format your page very well, it helps in SEO. Your website will be, Google will come to your website, they will go crawl on it, and then know what your site is all about. But if you did format it very well, you are not going to get a lot on the SEO. So the first will be home page. Okay, I hope it's what? index.html, that's our homepage. index.html, and here top about us, we put home page, or just write home. Then the next one should be about us, so it's already there. So just put about.html. About.html, and there you put about us. Then the last one should be contact page. Okay, so it should be contact.html. 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 Which will be contact.html, okay? Oh, sorry, I didn't put it very well. That's it, the way it's appearing. Also, to be there. To be in between, okay? And please don't make this mistake. Any mistake you make, you're going to pay for it, but it's not going to display. So make sure that what you're doing is correct, it's accurate, okay? So let's just close this. Let's replace it, Ctrl V. And let's come over there, clean it up, and put what we want to put, okay? So this should be contact.html. See, it appear now, contact.html. So that should is working, okay? Now here we should put contact us. So we've created a link for all three pages that we've created so far. And that is most of the pages you see on the website. Your home page, the Abaros page, and your contact us page. So let's do Ctrl+S to save. And as I told you earlier, don't forget, if you can also bring all of them down, how do you do that? Use your BR, okay? So just enter. I don't register here, you know it already. That's all, and then save again. That's for save. So we have home, we have Abaros, we have contact us. You know the beauty of all this? Although we've not done anything on our Abaros, nothing on our contact us. So if you click on it now, it will be blank. But let's click it, we go, but it will be blank. Let's go there. It will go, but it will be blank. Okay, so that's how, see it, blank. Okay, so I mean, we've done one or two things here. You meant to click on it, to also link you back to your home page. You click on contact, it will be blank. Back to your, so don't worry, by the time we'll do it, we're gonna do it here like indirect. Well, let's do it now. Let's go to our contact page. So what we did on our home page, this that we did on our home page, you just want to copy it. Copy this navbar of the home page, does the navbar completely straight to the end of it. Copy straight down. Copy. Then come to your about us page. This is my mouse. Come to your about us page. Click on it. And as usual, bring back your skeleton with your HTML skeleton. HTML5. And under here, put your title as about us. I won't explain, but we've done the definition when we're doing index.html. Okay. Simply put, the title should be about us. It should be about us. Okay. That should be your title. Then under the body, paste that you've copied before. Ctrl V for paste. And what do you do? Save it. And by the time we get to our backup page, so that all these things will appear there. Make sure you save your words. Let's go contact and do the same thing on contact page. Same thing, your H5. Sorry, HTML5. And the title document should be what? Contact.page. Or contact. Contact. Save it. And under the body, as usual, control paste it and use your control S for save. So be able to do all the buttons we have. You will see anything more than this. By the time we go there, you see anything more than this. Okay, this is the only thing I'm going to see there. So, but at least you can navigate your from your home page to your about page, my about page, to your contact us page. You go back to your home page. So at least you can navigate along that angle. Okay. If you are able to do it exactly like this, yours too will work. Test it. So from home page, this is our home page. Let's go to about us page. This is our about us page. Yeah. To my about us page, let's go to contact us page. These are contact us page. If you are checking up, you see the name contact. See contact us page. Okay. So from contact us page, let's go back to our home page, and we are back to our home page. So these are people navigate your site. Okay. Don't worry. But now we get to CSS. We'll make all these things you are seeing like this to look very, very beautiful, like a complete website. But just know now that indirectly we started building a website little by little. We are going there. We are progressively going there. So if you are using your mind, if you articulate enough, you are thinking very well, you know that indirectly we are already building our website one after the other. So from that formatting to this, we have started making a link on building our own website. So you know where we are going. We are going in there gradually. So time where they say, you don't need to climb there, sorry. Try to know all these things, learn them by heart, and try your best to always practice. Practice, and practice some more. So let's move on. Let's continue with what we are doing. Now we've learned how we can link to external websites like Google. We've learned how you can link to your web, your files, your website, internal linking. Now I want to also learn how you can link to files. To files like images, pictures, that images or pictures. How do you link to that? Let's get nobody else with an image here, but on the image nothing is here, right? Nothing is here. What do we do? Let's just close down this, close down everywhere. Let's move on. Close down. Remember the name, our name is still C-Web, right? I'm not mistaken. That's what I use. Still C-Web? Still C-Web, yeah, still C-Web. So go to your desktop. Open your the file you are using to work, and you see that every other thing you got is already there. Like you check here, you see about, you see contact us, you see index, you see index. So they are already there. Just the way two of them were, remember when we did using the Path++ to code, okay? It's exactly the same thing, but VS Code is doing it, but still bringing it to your own file in here. What you do, if you have any picture on your laptop or your phone, if you have any picture, have any picture on my desktop? I don't have any picture on my desktop right now. But I do have picture on this. So let's try and check that. Let me go to somewhere. I want to bring a picture from here and put it on our image. I'm gonna bring this. Let's check up. I think I should have picture of my downloads. I should have picture of my download session. I have a lot of picture here. Let me bring this one. Let me bring this. Put it on the image. You can drag it. You can copy and paste. Anyone you want to do, you can do. Okay. You can drag and copy and paste. I'll drag this one too and put it there. I would like to put like 2, 3, 4. Okay, let me look for more picture, maybe the red picture that I have. Pixia, let's go. I'm trying to get some pictures. So YouTube, get your pictures, try to get as many as you can. and put it there. But you make use of one or two, but then you know how to do it. So next time, I can put images. So I tried to, we were not yet on email, but by the time I get to images, you also learn about email. But now we're trying to use link. I can actually link to file, and if I want to just let the file be picked, okay? So we are still on how you can actually link. So I think this should be enough. Nothing much. This should be enough for this. So what we do is, all this piece that we just bring in here, click on it, right click, because we want to change the name. You just have to change the name. Must be either use .jpg or .png at the end of the piece, okay? And then let's make this one simpler. Let's just look pix1 or pix2. pix1.png or it can be pix1.jpg. So change all their names, just change all their names. Once we're through, let's continue. So drag and drop them on the image folder. Just like this. Drag and drop all your picture on the image folder. And remember, I actually create external folder for our image. There's a reason why I did that. I want to show you how I can actually link external folder. What I mean, not the standard folder, a folder. You know, normally we have a file. Let me show what I'm trying to explain. Sorry. Yeah, we have a file, right? These are our files. Okay. On other create file, think of file we create, right? But now I create a folder, and the folder I created is this image. So create a folder and put image, and that image put all your piece in there. We are going to see how we can actually get linked to other folder or file outside our file. Folder is a folder is outside our file. How do we link it? How do we link up to it? That's what we want to do now, okay? So just create a folder, come over like I told you here, at our file, go to folder, click on folder, type image, your JPEG or image or whatever, and then create it, okay? And let's see how you can actually link it up. I believe you save all your work now, so let's see how this goes. Now this image is from different folder. You know, the same folder with our file.html, folder.html, and index.html is on a different folder entirely. So, how did I get it? So, for you to get it using that same thing, remember what we'll do, the first type is your A, your anchor tag, okay? So, click on your A, and under the href, first of all, first put your first slash, okay? The back, don't put the first backslash. The moment you've done that, it'll show you about image and all that. So, click on image. Click on image, okay? Image will appear. We're not able to select the picture. So you click on, you see that there's a first slash, that image.png, another slash, and for you to now put the picture. Because you know why those slash are there? Because what we are working at is from different folder. Remember, we are doing the same folder, you don't see all those slash. Just write about, and it will appear about.html. Click on it, and it will just come. Okay? But for this one, you have to be a slash, second slash. Then you put your picture. First slash for you to choose the image, the folder name. Then second slash for you to choose what is on that folder image. What's on that image? Which is our pix, okay? So we select pix one, and as usual, do your work, and everything will fly, okay? So don't forget to do that. If you are able to do it this way, everything's going to work out well and good for us. So let's save. Control S for save. And let me make it more so you see, if you take care, it has appeared. My piece. And if you want this to go down, you know what to do, right? Use BR to bring it down. So let's bring it as a video on its own page. Let's differentiate it from our video. BR and Ctrl+S for save. Now we have my piece on its own. Click on it and see what it takes. Yeah, look at the image. That has been brought straight to the image. Are you able to do something like this? Try and be able to do something like this, okay? So we've done a lot. We've shown you how you can link to your image or your file, your folder, or another folder. You'll see how you can link to the file on that same particular folder that you have all your items. Also show how you can also link internally and you can link externally. Let's continue because we are making tremendous progress. So we really try our best to do our links. And let's go to the next one, which should be images. Okay? You know, we just put an image using link. That you bring your image right there on your website. Like most websites you see images there, you see articles, you see products, you know. How do you create, how do you bring those images? So they'll be there on the website and be looking very good. Yeah, but you do that using HTML. But that will get to see a test with API. You can try to take image of that like a boss, like just where you have your cards and stuff like that, okay? But HTML is the building block. You must put on HTML first and then design it, show the style that you want using CSS. But we are not yet in CSS, we are still in HTML. We are just going to bring down those images. But that will get to CSS, we now know how you can actually display those images. Then like when the way that someone displays products, right there in his own website for those selling products, okay? So join me as we hang on to the system and I'm sure you can use images in HTML. I'm Emmanuel, C-A-R-C-I, C stand for Chooks, I stand for Uquese, and the other one stand for Emmanuel. I just checked our time now. Our time is well spent, okay? We don't want to bombard you with so many things to learn. So we won't go to image today. I'm going to do image the next day. And remember, the moment we are through with image, we'll now go to iframe, video, and YouTube iframes. And that will be all for intermediate. They will know that we have through intermediate, we'll now move to advanced, okay? Let's not rush everything. We've really done a lot today. I would like you to go back, practice all the things that we've learned, okay? Practice as many as you can and try to redo them yourself. Remember, it has to be part and parcel of you. If you're just reading it or watching it like a mirror or watching it like a movie, it won't sink. So as always advise, watch it the first time, possibly second, third time, and then practice it. If you have a sharp mind of you, if you already know coding before now, you can watch it only the first time and then practice. But remember, watch and practice. Practice makes perfect. Practice, and practice some more. Let's try it out today. Tomorrow we start again. That is the next day, not tomorrow. The next day we start again, which will be our day 4. We start again at the roundup intermediate, and then day 5 we do advanced HTML and probably see if we can wrap it up. We're able to wrap it up, we'll do it the following day, and once we need to wrap them up, we now move to CSS. And in CSS, we now start using all these things we drop down to create our website. Okay, and in, like I told you. Under this intermediate, if you check very well, if you think very well, we're already creating a website indirectly. We're already building our website skeleton, okay? We're already building the foundation for our website. And that is where we are going. At the end of the day, we'll now wrap it together by creating a solid website using CSS and HTML. So see you in my next class, and regards to all your loved ones. Bye.